today I just want to walk you through how you would create a basic funnel. So first you're going to want to create a form, and then there'll be three steps after that. First one would be creating a landing page with your form on it, then booking a time page, and then a thank you page. So let's get started by creating a form. First, we'll want to go down here to Form Builder under the Marketing tab, and I'm going to create a new form for this example. So this part is pretty easy and self-explanatory. You have the form here. All you'll do is you will drag the fields that you want your leads or prospects to fill out. So the info that you're trying to get from them, first or full name, for instance, we'll throw in a phone, an email, and we'll throw in an address too. So pretty simple here. You also have the option to create custom fields. And so this, as you can see, I have this example. I have, what is your birthday? So, and that's a pretty good example to use. So I'll add a custom field. And here you have the option to select the kind of field that you want to add. So your leads will either be answering as a text, as a phone number, as a date, as a checkbox, as a numerical number. If I were to ask, what is your birthday? Then I would be using a date. So we'll go ahead and do that. Name of the field, I'll say, what is your birthday? Placeholder, I can leave that blank. But if you were to ask a question like, has our company ever worked with you in the past? Your placeholder might be something like yes or no. So kind of just gives them direction. Go ahead and save that. What we're also going to want to do at the end of a form is add a button with a call to action. So in this example, I will add this button. And I will say something along the lines of, book now. Full width. And then at the end, you're going to want to integrate the form. Now, I don't actually want to do this because I'm going to use a different form in the funnel example, but this is just a basic tutorial of how you would create a form. And you can play around with it a little bit too. For instance, if you wanted to add an image, you could put an image down here, choose a file. If you had your company logo you wanted to add there. So yeah, just play around with it a little bit. Next, we're going to go to funnels and click create new funnel, where we're going to make the first step of our funnel. So we'll go down here to funnels and websites, click funnels. I will create a new funnel. I will name this Go High Level Tutorial, create funnel. Now, the first thing we'll do is we'll add a new step. Now, each step you add will be a page. So for instance, if you wanted somebody to fill out a form and then be directed to a thank you page afterwards, you would need to create two steps. We'll be doing three here with an intermediate booking page in between. So in this example, name for page, for the first page, I will just say form page, because this page will have the form on it that we created. Then we will do edit page. So here's where you can begin designing the page. Now, this is just going to take some time. You might have to play with it a little bit, get the hang of it, and see what all possibilities there are with using this tool. To start, though, I'm just going to create a header. So we're going to do full width, going to add a row, add a column, and then add an element. Now, the element can be anything from a calendar, video, button, form, paragraph, bullet list, anything here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add an image. I'm going to go down here and select an image I already have saved and go high level. So here we have our company logo up top. And then down below, what I'm going to do is click this, do the same thing, add row, column, add element. And then here is where we're going to embed the form we created. So in this case, I'm actually going to embed a form that I created previously that looks a little better. And that would be the GSMM consultation. So as you can see here, we have the form, and above we have our logo. So I'm going to go ahead and save this. And then we're going to exit out and do a new step. So we'll come here, add new step. Now this one will be the booking page where they can book an appointment on your calendar. Create funnel step, edit page. So I'm going to go ahead and just do the same thing I did up top, put our company logo up there, row, column, element, and image. Back down here, like this. And then now below here, I'm going to do the same thing, add another element, and this element is going to be a calendar. And now this calendar should already be up here when you get high level, should already be in here, so you don't have to worry about making it yourself. Booking request, pick a date and time, so your leads can pick a date and time. I'm also going to want to add quickly some text here to give them a little bit more direction, and I'll say something simple like make that a subheadline. Small call to action, I'll say choose a time below for your appointment. Just a little text there, something that they can read. And then, so we'll save that. And then we will go back out here. And then we'll add the final step. So this is going to be a simple thank you page for when they complete the sign up for the consultation. We will do edit page. And I'm just going to skip this because I've already done it. Okay, so as you can see, our logo is back up here. Now I'm going to add some more text. I'll do a headline and I'll say thank you for scheduling a consultation. Then below that, I will add a subheadline and finish it off by saying something like, we will be in contact with you shortly. Go ahead and save that. And then we'll go back out of here. So this was a pretty quick example of how you would go about designing and creating a funnel. Obviously, the more time you spend, the nicer you can make it look. But it is a very cool feature of Go High Level. One more thing I want to add to about creating the funnel is if you want to copy a funnel, which can be pretty useful, then you'll go down to the clone funnel step, you'll click it, and then you can either clone a step in your own funnel. So if I click this, you will see the thank you page has been duplicated here in this funnel that I created. Or you can also do the same thing, but clone it in a different funnel. So that becomes pretty useful if you want to tweak minor things like colors or a company logo, or if you want to change the language, if you have a client that speaks Spanish or something like that, it can be pretty useful.
So I want to go over some technical things that you'll want to do after you create the funnel. And for one, you want to go to settings and domains and create a domain where the landing pages are actually going to live on the internet. So we'll go down here to settings and domains. And I already have one created. But what you do is you would go to your DNS provider and follow the steps and Go High Level to sync them up. And then it'll tell you when your domain is successfully added. The one we're using is consultation.globalsocialmediamarketing.com. So then you'll go back into your funnel and add the domain there. So in settings, we can add the domain. In this case, it would be consultation.globalsocialmediamarketing.com. And you can also add a favicon or tracking codes here. And finally, I want to add on by showing you how to connect Zapier to some of the funnel processes. And Zapier can be used to automate a lot of your Go High Level. And I'm not going to go through everything, but I do want to show you specifically how you can connect the forms that leads fill out this form to a Google Sheet automatically, because you're going to want to store that information someplace.
Okay, so what we're going to do is we are going to go down here to triggers, and we're going to add a new trigger. And I will just name this something like high-level form test. I'll put it in folder. And then, so what we're going to choose the form submitted, and then we're going to add another filter, define filter. We'll say form is. And then we want to choose the GSMM consultation form. And this is the one that we created quickly in our landing page where we can fill out, or our lead can fill out their information. So then we'll do add action. And then we will click execute webhook. And so this is where we need to drag in the URL for the webhook that we will find on Zapier. So we'll head over here to Zapier, and we will make a zap. And we're going to want to choose webhook. And we are going to put catch hook. So now we're going to get a URL to copy. Here it is right here. We'll copy that. Then we'll go back to high level and we will paste it in there. Okay, and now we want to go up here and change it from draft to activate. We'll save it. So now we'll go back to Zapier and we will test the trigger. Test trigger. So how we're going to do that is I already have this pulled up. This is the form we created. I'm just going to fill it out with my own information. Phone number, and schedule a free consultation today. Now, when we go back to Zapier and we test it, we should be able to see, yep, here it is. So we now connected our forms to Zapier. So here we have all the information that I put on the page, and then below that we have all the information about the website. And now the question is, what do we want to do with this information? So we are going to choose Google Sheets and choose an event. I'll just create a spreadsheet row, continue, sign into Google Sheets. I'll sign in really quickly. Okay, now that I am signed in, hit continue, and we want to choose a value. So I have already created a Google Sheet. I called it Go High Level Form Test here, and I have my first name, last name, email, phone, and it kind of matches up with this form right here. And so the information I put in here should automatically be transferred into these corresponding rows right here. So we'll choose my Google Drive, and then we'll choose the worksheet over here, the Go High Level Form Test, or spreadsheet, I mean, sorry. And then the worksheet at the bottom, we only have one, so we'll just choose that one. We'll continue. So as you can see here, the headers that I put in the worksheet, first name, last name, email, and phone, all popped up. So we just want to make sure that they are all synced. So we have first name, last name, email, and phone. We'll continue. And so this is just testing it. Let's test and continue. Spreadsheet row has been sent to Google Sheets, so we'll go back over here, and as you can see, my information is now stored in Google Sheets. I'm not going to actually turn on the zap because this was just a tutorial, but that's what you would do. And then all your information that your leads or clients or anyone fills out in the funnel will be transferred directly to Sheets, saving you the time it would take to manually get all that info in there. So guys, that is how you create a funnel and go high level. Hope you liked the video, and if you have any questions, just comment below. Till next time.